Welcome back to this channel once again. Today I am recording a very interesting video in IBM I subfile tutorial. So here I'm going to perform an advanced search in the loadall subfile. So earlier we have seen the search in a loadall subfile. So basically, when we search in a subfile, we just track, or we can say we just search the first record in that subfile. Okay, so we never just look onto the second record. So when we always press on enter after putting or inputting the search text, then we will be only getting the first occurrence of that search text. Okay, so that is a basic simple searching in a loadall subfile. Now I'm going to perform an advanced searching in the loadall subfile where when I'm pressing enter again on this after putting the search text on the search input, then I'll be once I'm pressing enter again, then I'll be getting the next record which is present in the subfile. And again pressing the enter will search for the next occurrence. Okay, so in case if no further occurrence would be found, then the first search record which was searched earlier will be searched again, or you can say opened again, and that will be you can say will be in loop till the time you are pressing enter on the same text. Okay, now what I'm saying, just have a look. Call pgm12. So this is the basic loadall subfile. So here I'm going to perform the advanced search in subfile. So you can see that there are three pages are loaded in this subfile, and total records are 22, and on one page we have only 9 records loaded, on second one also 9 records. So one page can have a maximum of 9 records loaded, and the last page has 4 records. So total records loaded are 22. So if I press enter on this one, so I'm on third page, so I'll be always on the third page. So if I'm on second page, I press enter, I'll be on second page. Now there's the turn for the searching. So for example, I am searching for name, this one. Okay, so if I press enter here, so I'll be getting the message record not found in subfile. Total occurrences found is 0, means there are no occurrences found in the subfile. Now if I press enter again, I'll be getting the same message again and again. So if I remove this search text and I press enter, I won't be seeing anything happen. So if I am on page 2 and I'm pressing enter on that one, so I'll be on page 2. So in whatever page at that current time we are on the subfile page, we will be on the same page. We won't be navigate back to the first page. Okay, now for example, I'm searching for name 2. Okay, so I can see that name 2 is found on the second page, so I am navigated to the second page from the page 1. Okay, and this row number is 2, so I can see that row number is 2 and subfile record is 11. Okay, because on first page there would be 9 records, and on the second page this is the second row record, so the record subfile record would be 11. Now if I press enter again, so I'll be seeing the message that no further record found. Press enter again to jump to first search record. Okay, also we can see from here total occurrences found are 1. So if I press 1 again, so I'll be again on the same record, and I'm again seeing the same message. Okay, so if I'm pressing enter again and again, I'll be on the same record. So this is having 1 occurrence, so we are not actually seeing what we have developed through this advanced searching, what we have done in this advanced searching. So for example, I'm taking name 1. Now I was on the second page, Now once I enter name one text in the search by employee name, this one, so I can see that total occurrences found are 3. Okay, so the first occurrence is found in the record found in page 1 row number 1, and this is the subfile record number 1. Now if I press enter again, so next record found, okay, record found in page 2 row number 5, this one, or subfile record is 14. 9 plus 5 is 14. Okay, so this is on the second page. On the first page there would be 9 records, and on the second page this is the fifth record, so 9 plus 5 is 14. So if I press enter again, so again next record found in page 3, okay, and row number is 1, so this one, so and the subfile record is 19th, because this is on page 3, so page 2 would have 1 and 2 would have 9 plus 9, 18, plus this one is the 19th record, okay, though, so the subfile record would be 19, and this is found in page 3 and row number 1. So all the total 3 occurrences found have been seen or visited by us in subfile by pressing enter again and again. Now if I press enter again, I can see that there would be no further records of name 1, so I'll be getting the message no further record found. Press enter again to jump to the first search record. Now it is saying that if I pressing enter again, I'll be jumping back to the first instance of the name 1 found earlier. So I'm pressing enter again, so I came back to the first instance of the searches. Okay, so I can see that name 1 was found in first page, first row number, and the first record. So pressing enter again, second page, fifth record, this one, and 14th subfile record. Pressing enter again, third page, first record. So doing pressing enter again and again, I would be just moving into the subfile from top to bottom, and then again came back to the top, and then we'll go traversed through the subfile to the bottom. Okay, so this would be like something automated, like here we are just worrying about what happened if we go back, come to the fifth search, and now I have to have search it. For example, there are 5 occurrences found, and now at fifth occurrence I would have pressed enter again and again and again and reaches to the fifth occurrence. Now I would have to again see the first reference, so I don't have to go back and then input the name 1 again on the search by employee name input field here, or defining both mode. So it will again come back to the first top first record, and then we'll traverse through the subfile till bottom. Okay, so this is the more advanced searching which can be performed in a subfile, and yes, this is possible in IBM i. Sure. So now what I'm doing, I'm just taking F3 from here, and I'll also show you that we can display the empty subfile also in that case. So how I designed this advanced searches in a load all subfile. So I did not done anything else, or I didn't do or did perform anything very advanced. This is just a simple concepts which I used. So I'll be showing you that how I did this. So let's start. So I just pick this file, a student file, so which have 3 fields: employee number, employee name, and employee status, in which employee number is the key field. Okay, and this is the R student is the record format. Okay, now if I look into the data inside this file student, so I can see that there are 22 records total, which will be loaded into the load all subfile and will be displayed to us. Okay, now come to the program. not to the program, just first come to the display file. Okay, now here you can see that there is a subfile record format which have three fields defined, same as the file fields which are defined in the student file. Okay, employee number, name, status, of same length, and these are defined in the output mode. Because we don't need to change anything, we are just searching in that load also file. So we decided to use output mode. Now these are the positions defined on which these fields will be displayed, and this is the subfile record format since SFL is used. Okay, the display size preferred was the standard one, 24 by 80. Now there's one more subfile control record format. So subfile control record format is using the SFL CTL keyword and having reference to the subfile record format, SFL format. So the subfile control format must be linked with the subfile format. Okay, here I use CA03 command attention key. So I'm using 03 indicator with this. So once F3 is pressed, so 03 indicator will be set to on. So once user presses F3, so CA is basically when we don't need to pass data from one screen to another. So here once I press F3, I will be returning back from the program. I'll be ending the program, so I don't need the data to be passed from one screen to another. So I decided to use CA03 in case I would have the requirement to pass data from one screen to another, so that the data for with those data I would be able to update something or perform something or some operation. So in that case I would be using CF03 command function key. Now here I can see that I have used the load all subfile since SFL page is not equal to SFL size, and I also can see that SFL size is set to maximum 9999 value, and on at a one time 9 records can be loaded into a subfile page and total of 9999 records would be loaded. Now you can see the overlay keyword. Overlay is basically to just display the records without deleting the previous records, okay, or existing records which are displaying on the workstation. So that's why overlay will be used. Now SFL clear and SFL display. SFL clear is keyword is just for, these are the mandatory keywords. Okay, overlay is not mandatory, but SFL size, SFL page, and SFL display, SPCTL are the mandatory keyword. Okay, so SFL clear is for clearing the subfile. So once we are clearing the subfile, so we have set an indicator with this. So we need to set this indicator to on. So 20 will set to on, then it will clear the subfile. So once the subfile is clear, we need to set it off, else it will be clearing always. Okay, if you are writing the records, it will be clear. So once you are done with your clearing the subfile, you need to first on this keyword, then you will clear the subfile. Okay, then you will again set off this indicator. Now SFL display and SFL DSPCTL is the control keyword which is associated with SFL display. So once you are ensured that you have at least one record loaded in the subfile format. Okay, so a student file would have one record and that record was loaded into the subfile format, then you will set this indicator 10 to on so that the subfile can be displayed, not empty, with some records. Okay, so if this was not set to on and you are trying to display the records, you will be getting the session or device error. Okay, so you must set this indicator as on whenever you have records loaded in the subfile, so that you will be able to display the subfile. You won't getting the session or device error. And in case if you are displaying the empty subfile also, you must set this off so that you will be able to display the empty subfile, else you won't be able to display this empty subfile and you will be getting the session or device error. Now here I used SFL record number keyword, and there is a field SFL RN which is associated with that keyword, and this is 4S0 and this is a hidden field. Since we have seen that when we are pressing enter without entering the search word, okay, without entering the search text, we will be on the same page where we are at that time. Suppose we are on the second page and we press enter, we stuck to the second page, we not navigated back to the first page. That will be the functionality of the load also file. And once one must have to you can say that one must have to deal with that, because that is an error. Okay, now so that's why I use this keyword SFL record number, and I'll be passing the current RRN. Whenever we are on the second page, we are passing the current RRN to that second or third page or any page. For example, on one first page, we are passing that current RRN of the subfile recalled, so that I would be able to be on that page when user presses enter. Now these are the heading information. As you can see, employee number, employee name, employee status, these are underlined or white color attributes. Okay, and advanced search and subfile, search by employee number, as you can see. And this is a field search 2, which is associated with the search by employee number, since this is defined in both mode. Total records also, and total R1 is the field associated with that, so 4A. And this is in output mode. So these are, we can see that these are on 1, 3 and 5 positions, and subfile format is on 6, started with 6 position. So the subfile control format must have the headings or whatever it can contain, it must be above the subfile format, right. For example, it ends on 5th position, so I cannot write these on 6th position, because on 6th position the subfile format field display started. So in case if I would be setting this 5 to 6, so during compilation time I'll be getting the overlapping error, since subfile control format is overlapping to the subfile format. Okay, now so these two both and output fields taken for inputting the search text or search name, or for this one, this will be displaying the total number of records in the subfile, loaded in the subfile at that time. Now here is the third record format, that is the footer record format, and we know that we are displaying the F3 to exit for that one. Okay, and we are also displaying the message total absences found. So we are not always displaying that message, we are displaying that message once user enter or input some name on the search by employee name field, which is defined in output mode in this in this subfile control format. Okay, then we will be displaying the total occurrences found. That will be either 0, or that will be either some number, maybe 1, maybe 2, maybe 3, or any number less than or equal to the subfile size. Okay, now I can see that that's why I associated one indicator 85 with that. And since we are displaying the total occurrences found, so this is the field which will be holding the value, that value 0, 1, 2, 3, or a value less than or equal to subfile size, because one load also file can have maximum 9999 records, so it can have maximum 9999 value. Okay, now we will be setting this on and off based on that once user presses enter, and it also enters some value on that search by employee name input field. Okay, and this is the 81, this is the page record found in page and row number and or subfile record, and the fields associated with those, page 1 row number for position 1 and position 2 is for subfile record. Okay, so we are setting 81 indicator with them, so that once 81 indicator will be on, we will be displaying this indicator, these messages. So once the record is found, basically record is found means at least one occurrence would be found in the subfile, then this indicator will be on and we will be seeing the message. So in case if no occurrences found, zero occurrences found, then we will be setting this 82 indicator as on, so that recall not found in subfile. Okay, we will be also setting 85 as on because we will be seeing total occurrences found as zero in that case. So 85 will be on and 81 will be on simultaneously, and 82 and 85 will be on simultaneously. Now 83 and 84, 83 will be on once we have found the next occurrences. See, means occurrences will be more than one, greater than one. So if greater than one occurrences are found, then 83 will be set to on, and if and this will 84 will be set to on if in case we have at least one occurrence. Okay, so in case we have at least one occurrence, in that case we will be seeing this message. So this is the subfile. So we didn't do, we have not done anything else. So we have only a simple subfile format, a simple subfile control format. We have some fields for input fields for inputting the name which needs to be searched in the subfile, and we have showing the, we are showing the total number of records loaded in the subfile, and in the footer message we are having some fields which will be displayed as a message to the user. So these fields are just taken so that user would be seeing the customized message, as you have seen in the demo. Okay, now just come to the program. Since I defined the student file in input mode, and this is a keyed file, so I have defined this student file in input mode with key file, and I defined this PGM12 DSPF in combined mode, since this is a workstation file, and I set SFS file. I also defined this a file format and associated the RRN with that. Now I just use the file information data structure with this subfile format, and just getting or fetching, you can say retrieving, the current RRN from these position 378 to 379B0. Okay, so why I am doing this? Because for example, I am on second page, second, third, or any page except from first page, if or on any page, when I am pressing enter, that will not bring me to the first subfile page. Okay, so for that purpose I'll be passing the current RRN retrieved from the file information data structure to the subfile SFL RRN, that is SFL RNN hidden field, that is I will be activating that SFL recall number, and that will hold the current RRN value, so it won't bring me to the first page and I will be stuck, or I will be on the same page or second or third page, whatever page I have opened that at that time, I'll be on that page if I press enter. So that's why I use this. So I also written this here. So we won't be getting this runtime issue in that scenario. Now I just associated the RN, as you can see. So I defined that RN here. Now since we know that we cannot read the subfile, okay, we can only perform the read C operation on the subfile. So what in the simple searching also we have seen that we took some one array to hold that value on which we are performing the searching. So here we are performing the searching on the name. So we defined the name array emp n1 of 10a, since the name is of size 10a, and I defined the size as 9999 initialized with blanks. Okay, so this is a name array, and this is the index associated with that name array. So it will hold the value of that array, okay, index of that array. So it will be used with this basically. Now we I took the total keyword total variable here to just show the total on the just calculate the total number of records in the sub file. This is the lookup index. This is the previous search. This is the array found RRN, and this is the array found RRN index. This is the total searched. Okay, so I just took these variables. These total lookup index, previous search, array found RRN, array found RRN index, total search recalled. Okay, so why I took these variables, I'll be explaining later in this program once they occur in front of us. I'll be explaining them to you. So we basically know that subfile, first thing what we do in the subfile, we will be loading the subfile. Okay, so after loading that subfile, what we'll be doing, we will be just displaying the subfile. Then what we'll be doing, we will be seeing the user intervention with that, means what user performed on that, if whether he pressed enter, whether he pressed F3, whether he just input the field that name or press enter, what he did. So we'll be capturing that basically either in the form of indicators setting to on. So we'll be capturing that, and then we will be taking decision based on that. Since for that is we are processing the keyboard keys. Now as we can see that the first thing is a loading, so that loading is performed in the initialization subroutine. Okay, since I just have to load it once, I don't need to load it again and again. I would have to load it once, and that will be done in the initialization subroutine itself. Now begin subroutine initialization. This one is the initialization subroutine. So here you can see that I have set the RRN as 0 first thing. SFL RRN is 0. Subfile record number is also 0 since there are no records loaded till now. Now I am setting these message indicators 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, which are used in the footer format, to off, so that I'm not showing any message on the footer right now, because I didn't I'm just loading the file. I'm not doing anything. Once the records are loaded and they are displayed to the user, then only I'll be taking some actions and will set these indicators on based on the conditions. Okay, now I am loading the subfile. So I'm executing the load routine. Now just come to the load routine, what it does. Here I am setting this indicator as off, 99 as off. I took this indicator just to take care of the thing. For example, if a student file has more than 9999 records, and I'm loading the subfile and it reaches to the 9999 records. So whenever it reaches to the 9999 records, means 9999 records are loaded in the subfile, load all the file, then the process will stop loading the records, because we cannot load more than 9999 records in the load all subfile. So we are taking this indicator for that purpose. So once it is set to on, it means that we reach to the 9999 value, and we won't be loading the subfile further. Okay, now we are setting the indicator 10 as off. I have explained this during the display file, so I'll be explaining it again. So here I'm not this is setting as off, since if in case, for example, there would be no records in the subfile, I'm not getting the session or device error, and I'll be able to successfully able to display the empty subfile. So in case I would have loaded the records in subfile format, then I'll be setting this on. Here I'm taking the total as 0, setting the total as 0. Now I'm just basically reading the student subfile from the first value, key value, lowest key value, which is employee number. Here the key is the employee number, so I'm reading from that. And there is a condition, not percent end of file till the records are found. I'll be loading that. And also stand indicator 99 not equal to on, means till the time SFL size value didn't reaches. Okay, so we'll be basically loading maximum 9999 records or less than that, in case if a file has less records. Okay, Now I'm at first point. What I'm doing, I'm setting, since the RN was set as 0 earlier in the initialization subroutine. Now I'm setting the RN as 1, incrementing the RN as 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. Total would be again 0 plus 1 is 1. Now I'm loading that employee name to this array emp n1 on the first RN, since RN was 1. Now what I'm doing, I'm evaluating the file field to the subfile field, subfile format record field, and then I am writing the subfile format. Since I have loaded first record in the subfile format fields, so I'll be writing their subfile format to update those fields that they are loaded. Now once, if RN reaches to 9999, I'll be setting this on, so it won't reach us till now. Now if RN is greater than 0, means one, at least one record is loaded into subfile, I'll be setting or activating this SFL display keyword. So I'm setting indicator 10 as on. Okay, I'm reading this again. So I'm reading all the records in the loop, and I'll be filling, I'll be incrementing the total RN, and I'll be filling them in the array, and I'm writing them into the subfile format, and then I'm writing the subfile format, and I'm again doing the same thing. So it will basically load all the subfile, all the records from the student file to the subfile, load all subfile, and also loads the array. Now if RN is greater than 0, what I did, SFL RN would be set to 1. Since I didn't set the SFL RN, and at the initialization subroutine you can see SFL RN is 0. So if I again won't set this as to 1, so I'll be getting the session only device error. Right, so in case if there would be records to display in the subfile, then we would be setting the SFL RN to the 1, since we will be, at the first time we will be displaying the first record of the first page, okay, and whose RN would be 1 for that subfile. Okay, subfile RN, record related number is 1. Now here I would have total value calculated in this of in the program, and that I'll be passing it to the subfile field, total R1, which is defined in the subfile control format by converting it to the character, since this is a character field and this is a numeric field. Now the loading is complete. What process will do? Process will then write the footer format first, then it will execute format the subfile control format, means it will basically rewrite and read the subfile control format. Since we have already written the subfile format, now I'll be seeing the, here at this point I'll be seeing the my subfile noted, where I can just do page up page down, because, and that thing will not be taking care here because this is a load of the file, and we don't need to take care of those page down and page up, which is internally handled by the process. Now user can do something here. Once the subfile is in front of user, user can either press F3 and or he can press enter. Now just come to the process keyboard keys subroutine here. So it will be, as you can see that it will be, after every execute format, user will take certain in, will give certain inputs on the subfile, and then this based on that input, this will be executed again and again. Okay, because I didn't written indicator star NLR as on. Okay, so process keyboard keys, so this subroutine will be executed after every execute format, write and read. Now if F3 is pressed, I'll be setting the last record indicator to on, and I'll be exiting or returning from the program. Okay, now the second choice to the user is, user either can press enter, check if enter key is pressed on the keyboard, handle the subfile screen display, display the current page, if search word is entered then find the search word. Okay, so if only enter is pressed, so here I can see that I don't have, if user would have pressed F3, so it would have returned earlier as well, here only. So he the process, or you can see that the program will not go to this part to execute if user would have pressed F3. So in case it would user would not have pressed F3, then in that case the process will come into the else part, then it means that user would have pressed enter. So here we will be checking whether he simply presses enter or he would have entered some word or some name into the input search by employee name input field. So here I am checking search to field of the subfile control record format, which is taking input of name. So here I am checking if it is blank, means user did not have entered that name to search. So he just simply pressed the enter. So what I am doing, I am fetching the current RIN from the file information data structure. So for example, I am on the second page and I pressed enter. So I'll be getting the RIN as 10 because one page can have maximum 9 records. And I'll be passing the second page first RIN to the subfile SFL RIN keyword. So I'll be passing 10 to this one based on the value retrieved from the file information data structure to the SFL RIN keyword. And then I'm setting this 81, 82, 83, 84 and 85 would have to off, and also previous search to be off. Means for example off, or you can say blank, because I just pressed enter without entering any key. So I pressed blank, I input blank. Okay, I'll be not searching for blank in the subfile. Okay, now so the previous search, so the current search would be the previous search for the next searches. Okay, so previous search would be set to blank. Now if user would have pressed enter and have entered some name, so the process will not go to this part, then the process will come to this part. Okay, here search for the employee name, I written number here, sorry for that. So here it will search for the employee name. If found, then open that page, else be on the page where we are currently. Okay, so now if user presses enter by inputting some name on the search by employee name field on the subfile, then if the record will be found, he will be navigated to that page and he will get some messages, customized messages out of from the program. Or if he want to get the record searched into the subfile, then he will be basically on the page. For example, if he is on third page and he's just inputted some word there on the subfile search by employee name input field and he presses enter, he will be always on the third page if we don't find any matched record. Okay, now here what happened, now again I am searching, for example, user can enter name one by starting from the second or third field on the third position from on the input field. So in that case also I have to just search that name. So that name, I won't just read those blank as some text. Okay, inside the name I'll be removing those blanks from the name. I'm just using percentage trim, search to is not equal to percentage trim previous search. So in case the previous search, for example I just input name one at this time and presses enter, and then if I then what happened, what I can do, I can just change the name and then press enter, or I would not be changing the name and I am pressing enter again and again on the same text. So this is the case handled here. So in case the search to is not equal to previous search, means the name which is searched is not equal to the previous name searched, then the process will reset these variables or fields in the program, defined in the program, for the next search name, or this in case if it is same from the previous search, it will not reset these fields. So I'm searching the total search as 0, since for every name searched the total search record will be set to some value. Okay, For example, I search for name one, I would have get three records. So three records, and then I again change the name to name two, I would have get the two records. So I would be setting this, resetting this total search field array employee number in array name array index field. So now what I'm doing, I'm setting these fields to zero, and then I'm in setting the lookup as one. So this is basically zero right now, and I'm setting this to one right now. So what I'm doing, I'm just looking up into that array using that search input, search name input. I'm using personal trim here. So I'll be searching that in the employee number. So here I use third, in the simple search, I won't be using this third parameter. In this advanced search, I'm using that. So I'm using this lookup index third parameter in which is optional in the lookup percentile lookup opcode. So here I am. If the record is found starting from that index, for example, currently I'm on the first index. If the record is found, I'll be getting array employee in one index greater than zero. So if till the time it is not equal to zero, I'll be operating this loop. So I'm inside that loop, total search record would be set to one. At that time, lookup index would be set to, for example, the record is found at the eighth position. So array emp n1 index would be set to 8. So now I would have to start searching again the next occurrence of that name from the next line or next record, so which would be 9th. Okay, so I'll be searching from 9th. Now I won't be searching from the 1 again. So if I would be searching from 1, I would be getting the 8th again. So I would be starting from the next position. So now lookup will become 9, and then I'll again search for this one from 9th position. The same thing written here would be written here. Now since the only thing change would be lookup index, which will be 9 here, and that would be 1 here at the starting point. So it will search from the 9th, it will find again. So it will basically what I'm doing here, I'm just basically calculating the total occurrences found. So this is the part which is actually calculating the total occurrence found. So here then I am converting that total search record to the character, and then passing this to the total s keyword field, which is defined in the subfile control format. Then I am setting this indicator to on. I am setting this indicator 85 to on because, as I can see that, eighty-five is associated with total occurrences found. Okay, so I would have some total occurrences. Either it would be zero if in case I won't find anything in the array, so I'll be getting array index as zero, and I won't be getting into this loop. I'll be getting zero here, and I'll be populating zero to this field. Now, since user has inputted some name, so I'll be passing this name to the previous search now. So this would become previous search for me. So if user would have pressed enter again, and that name would be matched with this name, so it means that user would not have changed that name, and he press simply enter again on that field. So to find the second occurrence, if present, though he would have seen the message for the total occurrences found, but he would or he might try to just check the whether subfile is working fine or not. So here I am now resetting the lookup index to 1, array name index to 1, to 0, array found RRN index to 0, clear array found RRN index. So why I took this array, I'll be explaining it here in this program later. So once I reach to this point, why I am clearing? So I am clearing for every next name searched into the subfile. I'm resetting these things: lookup index, array name index, array found RR index, array found RRN array also. Now lookup index would be set to 1. So I'll be starting searching the name from first position in this array name array of name, holding the names. So I'll be searching for the name which is inputted by the user. Now I'll be getting the array index. If it is greater than 0 means I have found some record. If it is not greater than 0, I'll be going to the else part. So I'll be moving to the else part first. So if in case I won't found that, so in that case I would have to be on that page only. I won't navigate back to the first page. So for that purpose, I would be passing the current rn to the subfile rn. So current rn is the tree from the file information data structure here. Now I'll be checking. So there might be two conditions possible. Okay. So first condition is on the first occurrence. For example, on the first time I press enter and I won't find any record, then at the first time it will come to the else part. Okay. So, and that might be possible that first occurrence is found and on the second occurrence it went come to this part, else part. Okay. Basically it won't found the second occurrence. Okay. So in that case it will come to this part. So it will check this one. If array found rrn index is greater than equal to 1, means if array search input, search name input was found either at least one time. So in that case, if it is found greater than equal to 1, we will be setting this 82 as on. So if it is greater than equal to 1, so we are setting the 82 as off, means we will not be displaying that record not found in the file. So we will be only displaying this message once we don't have found any occurrences. We will be finding 0 occurrences. So in case we will be finding greater than 1 occurrence, we will be setting this off, else we will be setting 82 as on. Okay. Now 81 would be set to off, means we will be not displaying this one also, this message also, that the record is found in this page, this row, this subfile record number. So we won't be displaying that message also. We will be setting 83 as off since no next record is found. Now for 84th one, I'm checking that if array found rn is greater than equal to 1, means if I would have found at least one occurrence of that search input, I'll be setting 84 as on, means no further record found. Press enter again to jump to the first record, else I'll be setting 84 as off. Okay. Then I'm clearing this array found rrn here because I would have traversed so the full path from top to bottom. I would be clearing this one and this index also, and then this will be end. If now come to the part where if the record is found into the subfile, I'll be setting this array found index to 1, incrementing it by 1, and I'll be storing that index. Okay. That index of name array on which that name is found, that search input name is found, I'll be storing this in array found rn array on the first index. Okay. Now I'll be passing this array name 1 index to the sfl rn so that if in case it is the first record and the last record which is searched, means only one occurrence is found, then we would be displaying that page on which that index, or you can say that name, is found. Okay. So that's why we are passing this SFL this to SFL RN. Then I'm checking if array found index is greater than 1. I'm setting this on, else I'm setting this off. Check. So I'm setting 83 or 84. So 83 indicator to on, 83 is just for next record. So in case I'm getting this later than when I'll be setting this to on, else I am setting this to off. So 81 is set to on since record is found. So I can see when record is found to us, we'll be setting 81 to on, and we will be basically displaying that page number, row number, or subfile record number. We'll be setting 82, 84 to off here. 34 is for no further record found till since we are finding the record right now. 82 is for record not found in the file since we are finding the record right now. Okay, so we will be setting these two indicators to off. Now we will be calculating the position 1. Position 1 will be getting calculated from the remainder. So for example, if we found the record on the first page, for example, that is the second record, so that means that position remainder will be 2. So we will not be getting to this one, so we will be calculating the remainder will be 2 since this is the second row. Position will be 1 will be treated as row, so this will be the second row record, and the page number would be that division 2 by 9 is 0 plus 1, that is first page second record. Okay, so in case if it is a ninth record, so in that case the remainder would be 0, so we will be getting to this one. So this is the ninth record, so the row number would be set to 9. If position 1 is equal to 0, we'll be setting this to 9, and then we'll be calculating the page number. So in case if it is 9th record, so 9 by 9 is 1, so here we'll be getting the first page 9th record. So in case if it is the 18th record, we'll be getting the remainder 0, we'll be coming to this one. So position 1 would be 9, means row number would be 9, but that will be the 18 by 9 would be second, so second page will be displayed, and the position 2 will be simply array name index. Okay, so at what index, at whatever index we are finding that one, so that index will be the subfile record number. Okay, now we are just doing the simple thing here, as we have already seen. So we are doing just this thing, so that's why we are just clearing this one. So let's have a look. Just compile this display file again and compile this program again with star source. Just do the strdbg here, pgm12 *yes*. So now I'll be setting the breakpoint at line number 1. Call this program pgmtill. Now at first instance, we are executing the initialization subroutine. So here we are setting these as off and 0. Now loading the records. Okay. Now the first record is found. So rn will be set to 1. Total will be set to 1. And array would be loaded. Eval ARR AMP N1. Okay, so the first record is loaded to this array as well, and the first record is evaluated to the subfile format field as well, and the subfile format field is written. Okay, if RN is 999, it will be setting 99 to on. So for now it is not setting 99 to on. So now if RN is greater than 0, I'll be setting indicator 10 to on for displaying the subfile. So we have at least one record. Now we'll be displaying the file, so this will basically load the subfile and will load the array as well. So I'll be just putting the breakpoint at this one. So here I can see that 22 records are loaded. So SFL RN would be set to 1 to display the first record of the first page. So the total is passed to the total R1 field of the subfile control format, that is 22. Now I'll be displaying, writing the footer and then reading and writing the subfile control format to display the advanced search in subfile page. Okay, so here I am seeing the total records at 22. Here I am seeing the search by employee name. Here I am seeing the employee number, employee name, employee status, And here I am seeing the F3 to exit. Okay, now I'm pressing page down. I'm on second page. I'm pressing page down again. I'm on third page. I'm setting page down again. I'm not moving to the next page because it is showing to me that no further records. Last record is to of the file. I'm doing page up, page up, page up. Then after on reaching on first page, I'm not moving to the previous since this is the first record. Okay, in a file. Now what I can do, I can just press enter, simple enter. Okay, so I press enter, indicator 03 is off, so I didn't press F3, so search 2 field is blank, so it will pass the current RN. So current RN is currently 1, so it will reset these fields, it won't go to this part, and this will display the subfile again. It will display the first page. Okay, so now I am on second page, I'm pressing enter. So what happened here? So here in this case the current RN would be 10 because only one page only can have 9 records, so that it will pass the second page first RN, means 10th RN to the SFL RN, and then it will display me the second page only. So it won't navigate back me back to the first page. As we can see here, we are on the second page. So our functionality is working. So that's good. Now, if for example, this is the case. Now, for example, I am now entering some name. I'm just entering this one. So just check, enter. Now this will come to not go to this section. It will check that such two has some value. Now it will go to this section. So it will check. So this is the first time I'm searching. So the previous search would be blank. So search 2 would have some value. So it is not equal to 0. So it will reset some values. So first time it will calculate the number of occurrences found for this name. So I just press enter. So it will take some time to look up into this array in debug mode. Just wait. Now as we can see that this line is executed, so the array employee n1 idx is 0 since no record found in this array. So if I do F11 here on the array, I can see that the array is loaded till 22th second record, so it won't have that value, so it won't search anything. It started looking up into the array from the first position, so it won't found anything, so it won't go to the this loop. So the total s would be 0. So the total occurrence basically are 0, search occurrence are 0. 35 would be set to on, means we will be showing that total occurrences found. Previous search, now previous search would become HDSJH. Okay, so it will clear some these variables. Lookup index again become 1, and then it will again search for the name into this array. So I'll be pressing F6 here and then pressing F12 so that it won't take time to execute. So I won't find anything with that name. So I'll be moving to the else part. So I'll be passing the SFL RN. So SFL RN will be 10 since we are on the second page. We press enter. We won't find that record. So we will be stuck to that page only. So array found RN index is greater than equal to 1? No, because we didn't found any occurrences. 32 would be set to on, means record not found. These would be set to off, is greater than 84 would also set to off. So after setting these on and off indicators, we will be finally seeing the display file. So we will be basically seeing two messages here: total occurrences found as 0 and record found not found in subfile. So if I press enter again here, so I can see that I again went to that part, so I can see search 2 again. So this is matched with the previous searches, so I won't get to this part, and I want resetting these variables for this one because I have already set the those variables for that search world. So I'll be again checking out. Okay, I press F10. Just take time. So I just come to this point, so I will be seeing that no occurrences found. So again I am just setting the 82 to on, record not found, and 84 to off. Okay, so 85 was already set to on. So I'm again seeing the same message, total occurrences found is 0, record not found in subfile. So for example, I would be setting this to blank again, and then I'm going to process this thing. So such 2 is blank, so I'll be moving to the SFL RRN part. So I'm passing the current RRN to the SFL RRN, I'm setting these indicators to off, and previous search which was earlier set to as some value that was searched earlier now would be set to blank because I have searched for the I have set the value as blank. So it won't go to this part, and this will give me this screen only, so it won't give me the messages because I just press enter. Okay, so now if I search for example, sorry, name 2, so it will search for name 2 here. Search 2, name 2, previous search is blank actually. Now it will search. So if it found that, yeah, it found that name 2 on the 11th position. So if I'll be looking, name 2 is present on the 11th position, right? So it started looking up into this array from the first position. So it is not equal to 0, total search record is set to 1. Lookup index would be set to 12. Now I'll be started looking up into the array from the 12th position because I found the record at the 11th position. So I'll be looking for the next record. Okay. So now I didn't find that next record. So the index would be set to 1. So I'll be exiting from the loop. Now the total records searched are 1, occurrences found are 1, 85 would be set to 1, so total occurrences would be set to 1. Okay, this message would be displayed. So previous search has now become name 2 and these will be cleared. Lookup index, again it will search for the 11th position. So it will, what it will do, it will increment the array found RN index to 1. And it will store those RRNs on which the records are found basically. So we'll have on 11th position, the 11th array name index position, the name was found. So I stored that index into the array found RRN. Okay. So now I'll be passing that index to the SFL RRN field so that I would be displaying that page Okay, so this record is found. So if index found is greater than 1, I'll be setting indicator 83 to on, means next record is found. So it is actually currently 1, so I am not setting that on, so I am setting that off. 81 is on since record is found, 82 is off, and 84 is also off. So I'm now again calculating the positions, okay, to display. So now I can see total occurrences found is 1, record found in page 2. So I can see that page 2 is displayed in front of me, row number is 2, subfile record is 11, that's correct, name 2. Now if I press enter again on the same world, I would go to this again. I won't be resetting these values since the current search name and the previous search name was same. Okay, I'm again searching for that. I'm not getting any further records found. Since I'm starting looking up into the array from position, from index to, okay, I'm setting these two off. Since this is one, so I'm setting this to 4 is on. So I'm seeing this message now. Since I press enter again, so no further recall found. Press enter again to jump to the first search recall. So if I would be pressing enter again, I would be jumping back to the first search recall. So now I won't go to this one because I didn't change the name. Now lookup index will become 1 again. Earlier it was 12, now it will become 1 again because I went to this part and I went to this part and the array name index was set to 0 since we didn't find the any further records. Okay, so it will search from the first again, so it will found record on the 11th position and it will display me the message record found in page 2 and row number 2 and 11. So if I will be changing the name, for example name 1, and pressing enter, now this will execute this section. Since name 1 current search name is different than the previous search name, it will reset these things and it will calculate the occurrences. So it will basically found 3 occurrences now for name 1. As we can see, on the first position and on the 11th position and on the 14th, on the first position, on the 14th position and on the 19th position. Now we'll set the current search as the previous search. Okay, now take F12, it will find the first occurrences on the first position. So it will update the array found RN also, calculate the position and it will display the subfile. Okay, now record found in page 1, row number 1, subfile record 1. So total occurrences found are actually 3. Just press enter, it will again go to this part, it won't execute this one. So now the lookup index become 2. Okay, because the first search word was found on page 1, RN 1, so it will start from the next RN. Okay, now it will find that name 1 on the 14th RN. It will update this array found RN. So I can see that eval arr found RRN array would have 2 records now. 1 and 14 positions are stored since we found the record on the 1st and 14th positions. So in case we just using this one to give the messages. The array found RR index is greater than 1. We'll be setting these set to on and off again. Still. So we are seeing the second page now. We are seeing the second page and we are set seeing the page record found in page 2, row number 5. And subfile record is 14. And the message again next record found. I'm pressing enter again on the same thing. I'm finding 19th now I'll be storing that in this one. Record found in page 3 and row number 1, subfile record 19, total occurrences found in 3, row number 1, this one. Okay, and the third page is displayed in front of us. Now if I press enter again, so looking up again, so just wait, it is executing this line. Since we are executing this in debug, so we are seeing this lagging, so it won't find the RIN, the next occurrence. Now it will set the current RIN to the SFL RIN so that to display the page that we are on currently. So if array found RIN is greater than equal to 1, means we are setting this indicator to off. 82 is off, 81 is off, 83 is off, 84 will be set to on. Okay, so why 84? 84 is for just to display this message, no further record found, press enter again to jump to the first search record. Okay, now press enter again. Now since the record was not found, array employee name index would be set to 0. Now it will set to 1 again, so it will find, okay, so this one again. On the first record, we again jump to the first record. On the first page, pressing enter again. Second page. Third page. Next record found. Enter again. So we can see that we are traversing through the subfile from top to bottom and back to top again, and then from top to bottom. So this is just advanced searching which we can perform, so we don't need to worry about to go back again to the call again the subfile program and then search for the same name to find the first occurrence again, or removing this name and pressing enter and would finding this another name and then find the same name again or the first occurrence again. So we'll be just pressing F3 to exit. Just doing end debug, calling PGM12 and searching form name 1. So we will be getting this information. So pressing enter again won't bring me to the second page, and again me to bring me to the third page, and then pressing enter will tell me that if you press enter again, you will be jumping to the first search record again. So I'm again back to the first record, second, third, and this is just now an advanced searching become for me. Okay, so you can also write this code or do this code at your end to just have a understanding how you can perform the advanced search in your subfile. Because basically we do the simple search to find the first occurrence only in subfile. So this is just a more advanced search where you will be finding the multiple occurrences of the same name or the same text in the subfile, and you will be traversing through the subfile from top to bottom, and you are again coming back to the top and again going back to the bottom. So the subfile till the time you are pressing enter on the subfile and with the same name. Okay. If you change the name, you will be getting the other results. So this is the thing which I just want to show you all in this video, and I think that this would be a very useful video and very interesting video to all of you, that you will be learning that how you can do the advanced search in a load all subfile. And that's all. Thank you and have a nice time.